just like having a glove, a ball, and a bat. Every kid owned a dirt bike.
I was young and strong.
Even if you weren't racing a dirt bike in the 70s, you owned one.
I'm on the bikes that I could never afford when I was 13 years old.
Now, in my older age, I'm building the bikes that I wished I had as a kid. Any one of these bikes behind me, if you showed up at your local track with that bike in the 70s, there would have been a crowd around your pits. You would have been expected to win.
And winning is something Scott Stevens knows a little bit about. He's considered one of the top vintage motocross builders in the entire country. Scott's won the coveted top honors, the People's Choice Award at the Nesco Dirt Works 4 times running. Looking at these replicas in the shop, you can see they're all clearly works of art, and riding them, well, that's a totally different animal. But the guys who made these bikes famous were stone cold rock stars.
We walked down and they had a red carpet all the way into the terminal. It was amazing. They treated me like royalty. It was absolutely amazing.
Marty Smith was the first ever superstar of motocross. He won the 1974 and 75 U.S. National Championships in the 125 class. And he did it aboard the first ever factory bike, Honda's RC1.
My first year with Honda was 1974, which is when they came out with the Honda RC. Before me, there was no RC.
That's insane. So if you ever meet a factory rider that you grew up with, he's your idol. I don't care if you're 70, 80, 90 years old.
When you're around them, there's a certain star power and you feel like you're sort of in the presence of greatness.
And then there's me. I'm Andrew Stack, and I was one of those kids from the 1970s who could never quite get enough throttle.
20 years ago, I was a fairly competitive racer.
You know, it was the dream of every kid to get a works ride. Up until I was probably in my 20s, I thought I was gonna make it.
And while Scott may not have gotten his works ride, he gets to build replicas of those factory bikes each and every day. Starting with bikes like this Elsinore. Looks like a stock bike now. Let's see what it looks like when he's done with his handiwork.
The addition of the uppipe was big. This also has a fiberglass tank that's modeled after the RC tanks, which is a little slimmer. Direct replica of Marty Smith's championship winning bike in 75. Everyone would have killed for this particular bike back in 1975.
We're gonna go track down the original rider that made the bike famous.
Right. Marty Smith was controlled, rarely ever made a mistake. No one was even close.
Would you be interested in turning a lap on it?
I would do a parade lap on it, like the old days. Do a few cross-ups. Amazing bike, amazing power, amazing torque. It almost didn't feel like a two-stroke. It had so much grunt.
Having them ride one of my bikes or even pay attention to one of my bikes is a huge compliment. You know, that's what I kind of think about when I'm working on the bikes. What would these guys think if they saw it, and how close can I get it to looking like the bike they raced?
That bike was so far ahead of its time. Guys that come from back in my day, that two-stroke sound will always be in your heart. It was amazing. It was amazing.